Hey guys, welcome back. So today's Chit Chat today, we are going to be talking about cooking things, wine, food. I have some channels, some YouTube channels, some fitness related things, some lifestyle things. I want to include a little bit more of myself in today's video. Since the beginning of my channel, I've always truly stuck to who I am and try to share everything that I enjoy besides makeup and beauty. I do predominantly makeup, beauty, fashion things here on my channel, which are totally me and things that I love. But there's other things and other facets and layers to me of things I enjoy too. And I like to watch those kinds of videos. And so I feel like there is a place to share more of these types of things with you. So welcome if you are new. Please subscribe. And if you enjoy this, let me know in the comments. Thumbs up this video and we will do more types of like favorite-y type videos or just bringing things to you that aren't just makeup and beauty related. When I first started my channel, I actually had a series called What's in My Kitchen, and if you want to go back, I do have a playlist of those older videos. Mind you, they are almost 5 years old at this point. In those videos, I shared with you things I was cooking, things that recipes I was trying, different kitchen type gadgets that I like to use when I'm cooking. So the first thing I want to share with you is something that I've recently picked up, and it's kind of replaced an old product that my mom had given to me years ago, and I was looking for something more sturdy, put it to you that way. And so what it is it's this colander by the Pioneer Woman. And I don't know about you, but I love to watch the Pioneer Woman on the Food Network. She originally started off as like a photographer, and she has a blog, and she does recipes. She has her own cooking show on the Food Network, and I love watching her. And my kids actually are engaged in her show too, because she shows her children playing outside and cooking in the kitchen. And it's just a really good show. And she has her own line of products, cooking products, kitchen gadgets, silverware, all kinds of things. So this is from her line, and I love the colors of it. So when I say my kitchen, I mean like my stuff that I own, because we're military, we've lived in several different kitchens. I never have the same layout. I never have the same cupboard space. I'm always trying to make things work. And the old colander, I just hit myself. The old colander that I had was from Tupperware, and it wasn't sturdy, and so you'd put it in the sink and your noodles would fall, and it was just not good. So I wanted something that I could put in my sink and it would not tip over and my noodles would be good. I actually also like to use colanders like this in the centerpiece of my counter or my table. You could put like a placemat underneath or a table runner or whatever it is that you'd like to use, even like a block of wood, and put fresh fruits and vegetables and just kind of display them out. This is so pretty that it would actually work. Why do I keep hitting myself? It would actually work really well as a table centerpiece and, of course, as a colander. So I wanted to share that because I love the colors. No matter what color your kitchen is, I think this would probably pair really well. And I'm a fan of bold, brilliant, lovely, bright colors. And so this just suits my style very well. We're just going to continue on with the Pioneer Woman because I really love her stuff. At Christmas time, she had the cutest Christmas plates and bowls, and I bought a whole bunch of pieces and I use them for Christmas breakfast. Scroll back in my Instagram to Christmas time and you'll see my Christmas breakfast that we had made when we had family here, and you can see the plates that I'm talking about. Next, I want to share this. This cute little dish like this is multi-purpose. Use it for whatever you want. I am currently using it for salt. So when I'm cooking, I don't have to sit there and shake all the salt out of the shaker into the soup or whatever that it is that I'm making. This is much easier. And when a recipe calls for a pinch of salt, instead of me guessing what that pinch size is, literally can just use a pinch of salt. But if you watch any cooking show, they almost always have salt laid out like this. And it's because it's so much easier. You don't have to like, obviously it's easy to measure it, but you don't have to like screw off a cap or try to get a utensil inside a salt shaker. It's cute. It's adorable. And it matches the... Oh, that's where I was going with the colors in my kitchen. I have a hard time finishing my sentences sometimes. My brain's constantly thinking about the next thing, and I sometimes don't finish the previous statement. I have a lot of red in my kitchen, and mustards, and oranges. Just like deep saturated colors. And I also have Rachael Ray pieces that coordinate really well because Rachael Ray has this blue colored, I have some pans of hers and some utensils that are this color. So I really, my kitchen's like all these colors. And the last little thing I wanted to share with you are these cute set of measuring bowls. I actually leave these out next to the salt and my utensils, because when you're cooking, you don't have to like rummage through the drawer looking for something. You can just grab these little things to measure out what you need. Each little one is different, and they're so cute because they're like a nesting bowl style, so it's not like it's taking up a bunch of space. So that's a third cup. Then we have the half a cup. Oh, so cute. And then the one cup. They also kind of remind me of something a little bit vintagey or something my great-grandma would have had. And I really love a classic vintage style as well, something that is kind of timeless. And I think these fall into that timeless category. And I guess I'm not sure when she was creating these, if that's what she was going for, but if she was, she most certainly nailed it. Also, those things are very inexpensive. They are not, if you have a Walmart, your local Walmart probably sells those. Otherwise, they are available online and I will link them below. I did not expect to like this at all. This next thing is a wine. And I do have a bunch of wine recommendations. I have an entire wine recommendations playlist. I try to incorporate my wine favorites every single month in my monthly favorites as well. So I've tried a lot of things over the years now. And in general, Pinot Noirs are not my favorite. They're a little bit lighter of a red. I'm more a Cabernet, Merlot, Zinfandel kind of gal. And Pinot Noirs are just lighter. I compare it to like coffee, like your Cabernet, Merlot, Zinfandels are going to be more like a medium to dark roast coffee, whereas a Pinot Noir is a lot lighter. It feels a little bit more like a light cup of coffee would feel like a light roast. And so I don't like that really light roast feel too much because it's a little bit more tea-like to me. However, this is divine. And I seen one of you comment that you love this wine and you have it all the time. And I'm like, oh my gosh, I just bought that and I've been converted. So if you love this wine and you know of any other Pinot Noirs that are similar in style to this, let me know because I am a true believer. This brand, actually, I've been trying a lot of their, let's see, I tried a Chardonnay from them and I think I tried something else. It's really lovely. It's Meiomi. This is a vintage 2016 Pinot Noir. It's a blend from Monterey County, Santa Barbara County, and Sonoma County in California. They nailed it. It is so good. I have some more cooking type things that I'm going to talk about, but let's kind of change things up for a minute. And I want to talk about a couple YouTube channels. So the first channel is a beauty channel, and her name is Megan May. She's from somewhere in the South, deep South. She has an amazing Southern accent. She's adorable. She has impeccable taste. Like, I watch her videos, and it's like, I love everything she talks about, like her personal style, how she carries herself. She's just very sweet, very kind. I think you would really enjoy her channel. I know she does fashion things. She just did a Nordstrom haul. She does have children too, so if you have children, if you're a mommy like me, you could totally relate to that part of her. But even if you don't have children, you will instantly fall in love with her because her delivery, how she speaks, she's just so sweet. So I will link her channel below. Head on over and subscribe to her. I know you're going to instantly fall in love with her. All right, I have a couple fitness channels that I want to recommend to you. I just found these people. The first channel is called, it's called HASFit, but it stands for Heart and Soul Fit. They do workouts. And I don't go to the gym anymore. I did the gym for the past few years, but, you know, it's expensive to go to the gym, and it costs gas and time and money to travel up and do that. I say up because it was quite a drive and there's always traffic. And so now we're back to working out in my home. And for me, a 30-minute workout is about max time that my children are, you know, able to find something to do on their own without needing a mommy intervention, if you know what I'm saying. And I just really love these two. They're a married couple, and they get you going. There's all kinds of workouts that they do. They have weight workouts. They have HIIT training, high-intensity interval training. They have, I don't know if they do any, like, yoga, or I know they have some beginner things. But anyways, I really like the channel. And it's actually, like, the workouts that they do feel like a true workout. And I think no matter what your fitness level is, they always have a modifier. And then he does the more advanced. And, of course, if you ever want to up your workout, up your weights, up your intensity, those types of things. And so I've really been enjoying that channel. I wanted to share them with you. And the second one is Yoga with Adrienne. So she has a variety of videos and different types of yoga things. And when I was going to the gym, I'm used to doing like a yoga vinyasa, like a more of like a flow type thing. But she does like, I mean, some of her titles of her videos are like yoga for stress or yoga for runners or yoga for whatever it is. So like if there's a specific thing you want to work on or if you're feeling a certain kind of way, she has workouts that are tailored towards whether it's an emotional need or a physical need that you have. And she's so calm and she's easy to understand. She doesn't talk in like a like a yogi type language where they're using really difficult terms where you have to like look up and be like, say what? What am I supposed to be doing? Like, she just is real down to earth and just very simplistic, and she's just really easy to listen to. So her channel is also really awesome, so I would definitely check that out. So going along with fitness and being buff and strong and all those good things, I gotta tell ya, I have seen these before and I never took the plunge to buy them. They come in an assortment of flavors, but my local grocery store, H-E-B, hello, has these in the store. And so now that I tried these two flavors, I'm gonna have to go back and start slowly trying all the other ones. But the first one, they're by Buff Bake. So Buff Bake is peanut butter, right? But it has protein in it. So it's not just peanut butter, which peanut butter on its own has protein in it, but this is like extra protein. So what I like to do with these is I eat frozen waffles like every day. So I like to put peanut butter on top of them instead of syrup. And this is 11 grams of protein per serving. And it only has 3 grams of sugar, which is really low. 10 grams of carbs. I don't look at all this stuff, but I'm just letting you know. But anyway, so this flavor is cinnamon roll. This is really good. This is really good. So another way to use peanut butter, well, there's lots of ways, but you can make cookies with this. You could throw it into a smoothie. Put it on toast, like I already said, and put it on a banana. You know, just eat it with a spoon, whatever you want to do. So that one's really good. This one, I'm kind of on the fence about. I bought it because I was intrigued. This is birthday cake. And it indeed tastes like birthday cake, like peanut butter birthday cake. It's different. I think the majority of you would prefer this one. This one is good, but I probably won't rebuy this one. The Rocky Road is probably the next one I'm going to buy because I'm thinking about how good that would be. And I think they have like a cinnamon something or another, but yeah. So, I mean, protein plus peanut butter, I mean, you can't go wrong. Now, this last thing I want to talk about is something I've shared before, but it fits in a little better with this video, I think, because of the topics that we're talking about. This was a gift to me, and I'm sharing it because I think it makes a wonderful gift. It makes a beautiful centerpiece on your table, and of course, its practical application would be that it is filled with entertaining ideas, decorating ideas, and recipes. And so this is called the Forest Feast Gatherings, and this is by Erin Gleason. Look at the cover. It just screams me. I mean, this is all, like, the way that she displays her food, she shows you how to decorate, she shows you how to completely plan a dinner party in different sections from start to finish, what you should be doing ahead of time. Like, she lays her all out. So, and everything that she serves it on, do you see? Like, this china is how she serves it. I just love old china. So anyways, she has a cabin. Her family has a cabin in Northern California, and they do a lot of entertaining, and she really breaks it down. Look at the pictures in this book. I mean, just to look at this. She does fresh flowers in all of these pictures. She has her own, like, herb garden and flower garden, and she just really shows you the recipes are super simple. I mean, if reading small words is a problem for you, you'll love this book because everything's, like, big letters. You don't have to squint. There's pictures on every single page. Cocktails, tons of cocktails, and it's all like laid out according to like themes. So maybe you're having like, oh, come on, it's such a beautiful book. The photography alone is worth, oh, it's just such a beautiful book. Oh, and I kind of mentioned the whole point of this book, which is these are all vegetarian meals. Now, I was not familiar with how to cook vegetarian. Yes, I know how to cook vegetables, but that was kind of the beginning, the end of my thought when I thought about vegetarian. I'm like, well, I can cook corn and carrots and that kind of thing, but how do I make this into like an actual meal? And my friend, who is a newer friend to me, is a vegetarian. And so I've learned so much from her and she's completely inspired me to step out of my box. And then she so kindly gifted this to me. It's like, okay, now I can't get this wrong. I can't get this wrong. I mean, grilled pineapple. There's a lot of really good summer, like right now it's summer, it's hot. There's a lot of good ginger mint lemonade. A lot of good summery recipes in here. The photography is beautiful. Everything is so simplistic. It's just, I think, I own a lot of cookbooks because I love cookbooks. And I think this is by far my favorite cookbook from the layout to the whole idea, the entertaining ideas, the colors. It's so gorgeous. And it makes even my husband, who is a major meat eater, makes me think of Ron Swanson from Parks and Rec. Like, there's no turning him. he's even like, I tried a few of these recipes already, and he's like, oh my gosh, that was actually really, really good. I'm like, yeah, I agree. So that is everything that I wanted to share with you. Thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know if you like this. If you'd like to see more lifestyle and fitness and food and cooking types of things here on my channel, because there's a lot more to me than just putting makeup on my face and talking about the latest shoes, you know? And so I want to kind of like bring more of a more well-rounded channel here. I kind of strayed away from that, you know? You kind of start going with the general consensus of what the crowd is doing, but you know what? It's like, I don't want to do what the crowd is doing. I want to do what I love. And I love to bring you all different facets of me and share things with you because I like to learn more about people. Like, that's why I watch the channels that I do, is because I like when they just go off and chat about all these different things, or like stories or things that are happening in their life. I can relate to that, you know, and I like to get to know the people that I'm watching and supporting. So thank you guys for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day, and we will chat very soon. Bye guys.